Tall grass. Mm-hmm. Little flower, like wildflowers. Mm-hmm. Trees sporadically dispersed.
Mm-hmm. What else is in this place?
There's wind flowing between the grass leaves. Mm-hmm. It's sunny.
Sunny. What's it feel like there?
It's warm. Mm-hmm. Feels like there's traveling to do, like move towards something else.
All right. Do you feel like you need to travel in this place?
I feel like I need to walk.
All right, so let's walk and see what's going on in this place. Where are you walking to? Tell me everything you see along the way.
I'm walking towards a, like a, there's, it's on a cliff. It would be a cliff if I was out on top, but I'm in the bottom part. Mm-hmm. So I can look up, and there's like, almost like jagged rock.
Jagged rock. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
It looks sharp, so I can't really.
What color are these rocks?
It's like yellow, like chalky, sharp. Mm-hmm. So I'm just looking up at them.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at yourself for a moment. Look down at your feet and tell me what you're wearing on your feet.
Can't tell.
Can you see your feet?
I see like plump feet, like sandals. Mm-hmm. I'm short.
Mm-hmm. Can you describe yourself? Imagine you had a mirror in front of you.
Probably 3 feet tall. Mm-hmm. Almost like a trollish, just mm-hmm. like plump, sturdy, strong female.
You're a female?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I almost have like little freckles.
Mm-hmm. What color is your hair?
It's like reddish. Like earth, mm-hmm. Copper.
Copper color hair. Is it long or short?
I feel like I have two ponytails. Mm-hmm. Like short, like ponytails.
How old do you feel there?
Like 23.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out where it is that you're going. Tell me everything you see along the way.
On my right side, there's a cliff, like the cliff part, and then the grass is turning into sand. Mm-hmm. So on my left side, it's the ocean. Mm-hmm. And I'm kind of just walking in between, like the narrow between the ocean and the. Rocks now.
Is there a path there?
Yeah, but not like it's a natural path where it's just people have been walking through it. Mm-hmm.
So let's see where you go next.
On my right side, there's like a little village. Mm-hmm. It's like straw.
Straw houses?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like round shaped. I feel like everyone's just like playing. Like they're just like having fun.
Mm-hmm. There's nobody working there?
No.
What are they playing at?
There's no activities. It's just like almost like jumping around and like mm-hmm. just like
Having fun?
Having fun. Like, no worries.
What about you? How do you feel?
I'm more of an observer. I feel like maybe I need to worry about something, or I have the responsibility to take that burden so that everyone else can have fun.
So let's see what it is that you do. I want you to see yourself doing the role in this village.
I feel like I've just protected.
You protect this village?
Yeah, but it's not physically protected. It's just like emotional or energetically protection. Just for so that everyone else can just be thankful.
Let's see where it is that you live. I'd like for you to close that scene and see yourself in front of the place that you live. Where are you?
I'm in the little, like one of the little huts outside. Everything is really minimal. There's like a table and there's like writing utensils. And that's where I write stuff, write things.
Let's see what it is that you do. What do you write?
I write stories.
Let's find out what you're writing about now.
I see like calligraphy, but I really can't see words.
So use your mind, connect with this book, and the pictures or the story will come out. What is the story about?
It's like that. It's writing a fantasy story. Like it's again. I think we're like little trolls, and as the others have fun and enjoy themselves, I kind of take those memories and sum them up, or just write them down. There's a human element to it, but we're not that human part.
Okay.
We're just like the sprites, or like the joy that we create. And I write these down so that the others that are having fun don't have to think about it. There's no memories, they just have fun, and I write down the memories.
So they just live in the moment, and you write down what happened? Do you remember the memories?
Yeah, that's my role.
That's your role.
It's, for some reason, I'm just really sad now.
How does that feel to have that burden of having all those memories?
It's sad. It's a big responsibility, so I have to be as accurate as possible. So nothing is taken advantage of or misconstrued. So it's real and true.
Do you write every day?
Yeah.
So you're just the one who...
I'm like a scribe.
The scribe of the village. So let's see what else is going on in your life. Is there anyone special in your life?
No. I don't, no. I'm not allowed to.
You're not allowed.
No.
This is all you do, is write down. So let's leave that scene now. Let's go to a scene where you are observing something that's happening that's very important. Very important for you to write about. See yourself there.
I feel a little bit angry. Because I'm 23, I'm still pretty young, and I'm resentful.
Tell me why.
Because I don't get to have a life like the others. I don't get to just enjoy. But I know time is passing, so I'm missing out.
What are you missing out on?
Connections. My society, like that happiness that I can't feel.
Are you not allowed to feel this?
No, because then it's I won't focus on what I have to focus on. So I'd rather not taste it.
So what are you observing now? What's happening at this point?
Kind of shifting into like this like parallel like priest mode.
Tell me what happens.
Now I'm wearing a robe. It's black with a cross, like a heavy cross. It feels heavy on me, at least. That burden. Then again, I get to watch and observe and write down, but I don't get to enjoy that. That's that sadness.
Are you still in the same personality?
No.
Same body?
No.
All right, tell me.
It's transferred into...
Okay, tell me what you look like now.
I'm a priest. Long black robe. Again, I'm writing down, transcribing. And that's where that sadness was coming from, is this person. Resentful. Regretful, but I know it's important to be doing this work, so I have to do it, and I want to do it, but I know I'm missing out on life.
What are you writing about?
I'm just transferring one book to another book. Maybe I'm translating. I'm assuming it's the Bible or something holy, something with meaning, something that I'm really passionate about that needs to survive.
What do you feel like when you're writing this? What's coming through?
I feel like I'm a tool.
Tell me more.
I'm a tool because that's my technology. That's I'm technology. I'm a tool. I'm transferring data into for the future. Because it's degradable, so it needs to. I'm that. I still have like my fantasies of like having a family and having a wife and being lustful and like just enjoying, but I have to mute down that pleasure or that.
How old are you?
27.
So take a look at what you're writing at now. What is this book that you're writing? What's it about?
It's the Bible. It's not my words. I'm just literally transferring from right to left, right to left.
From one book to another?
Yes, I'm just copying the book for the future. So that when one book, if it gets destroyed, that knowledge is not lost.
What does this book look like? How big is it?
It's thick. It's bound, leather bound, stitched about 3 or 4 inches thick.
Mm-hmm.
It almost feels like it's not hieroglyphics, but it's like it's just a different language.
Mm-hmm.
Like ink, it's like curlies and like it's really pretty to mm-hmm. look at.
What?
But it's yellow.
It's yellow. The book is, the paper is yellow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, I feel natural, like the paper feels natural. I feel like it's like, time will take its toll on it.
Very good. What is the ink that you're using? What does it look like?
It's just black ink.
Mm-hmm.
A little metal inkwell.
Mm-hmm. Very good. How is it that you're dressed in this place? You said you had a black robe. Anything yeah. else?
I have like, I see little like the edges. There's like a shirt under, like white underneath.
Okay.
So it's like billowy. It's a little billow, like the red, black part is billowy. Like if I'm not careful enough, like I can, it'll touch the white ink. So I'm really careful.
Mm-hmm. Do you wear anything on your head?
A little cap.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm bald.
Mm.
But there's like a cap. I can feel like the.
And where is it that you are doing this? What's this room look like?
It's like it's cold. It's mm-hmm. like stone. Almost like carved stone. Like.
Very good.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see anything else in this scene that's significant?
I'm always alone.
You're always alone. All right. So now let's leave that scene and let's go to another scene in that same lifetime when something else is happening. Move ahead.
I'm in a room or like the diner area.
Mm-hmm.
There's other men, other priests. Like having dinner, or I mean, they're not eating yet, but they're like sitting down to eat, and I feel like I'm a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
Like I need to eat.
Yes.
I want to go back to what I've been doing, like my writing, my transcripts.
Mm-hmm.
So in a way, I don't feel very connected to the rest of the men.
Mm-hmm.
The priest.
Are you the only one who does this?
No, but everyone is very secluded.
So you all have that same role?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's leave that scene now. Let's leave that scene. Let's go drifting and floating to another lifetime. Another lifetime that's impacting your life now. You can tell me when you get there. Where are you?
I don't know. It's still dark.
Mm-hmm. Allow yourself to acclimate to the place.
It's like a little cabin.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a family cabin.
A family cabin?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's like we all live in there.
How many are you?
Like five, three kids and like a couple.
Mm-hmm.
Like the father and the mother. I don't know where I fit there yet. I feel like I'm like the youngest, like a child.
Tell me more.
Like I'm kind of a baby. Like maybe I'm 3-4 years old. Again, I'm just like looking at everyone doing their to-dos, and I'm just observing.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can see like my mother like bending over and like clean, like, you know, like cleaning, doing her duties.
How is your mother dressed?
She has like four layers of like cotton clothing.
Mm-hmm.
Like she's kind of like leaning down, so she's like, so you can see like the layer, like the, there's layers.
Mm-hmm.
They're like baby blues and like pinks, like natural coloring.
Mm-hmm.
Dyes. I don't know why I can pick up on that, but that's that. It looks like it's been dyed by like by her, by hands, like.
Mm-hmm. How long is her clothing?
The like down to the floor, like.
Mm-hmm.
The like the really long skirt.
Mm-hmm.
And then kind of like flowy, like her shirt, like a billowy, like loose.
Mm-hmm.
Everything seems like loose except for like the waistline, like.
Mm-hmm.
That's more attached. And she just has like a bundle of other clothes, so like everything is just really like fabric-y. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
How to explain it.
And how are you dressed?
I like little overalls, little.
Mm-hmm.
They're really comfortable.
So let's find out a little bit about what you're doing there. Take me through the scene and let's see what's happening.
I feel like my father is really abusive, like really man, and like.
Mm-hmm.
Just aggressive and like plays the role of the man.
Mm-hmm.
and abuses like my mother.
What is he doing to her?
Just belittling her.
Mm-hmm.
Screaming. It's more of a dominance thing. Like there's little love there.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel when you see that?
I kind of want to grow up. Mm-hmm. So I can stop it.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'm connect, like I can sense that sadness and fear and just like control.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm connected to my mother, so I want to stop it.
Take a look at your mother's eyes, the eyes of the windows of the soul, and see if you recognize her eyes in anybody that you know in the life of Jaime.
I feel it's my mother now.
Mm-hmm. Look around and see if you recognize anybody else.
No.
Okay.
Like the father is just like almost like cold, like there's nothing inside of him.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's close that scene and now let's go to another scene in that same lifetime when something important is happening. See yourself going forward. Tell me where you are.
I'm in the same cabin, and I'm like 17. I feel like I'm finally grown up enough to like stand up.
Mm-hmm.
To my father's abuse.
What happens?
I see we're fighting. We're like physically like in a fight, and I see myself putting my left arm like protecting myself.
Mm-hmm.
But also exposing like my ribs.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm stabbed.
Where are you stabbed?
On my left, like the left side of my torso, like my ribs.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like a dance, like I lift my arm, my left arm, and he comes in with the knife.
Mm-hmm. What happens to you?
I die.
All right, so before you leave that body, before you transition away, I'd like for you to just look at that body.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like for you to remove that injury from your body. Is your knife still in there?
No.
All right, go ahead and use your mind to seal that area again. Seal that entire area. As if it never happened.
Okay.
All right. So now let's leave that body behind, leaving that man there to continue. And as you look back at that life, tell me, what was the purpose of that lifetime?
It was to regain control of myself.
Mm-hmm.
And to balance, like, the power, like, to stand up to the power struggle.
Mm-hmm.
And the dominance, and to take a stand, even if it meant my life.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you accomplished what you came here to accomplish?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What lessons did you learn from that lifetime?
I learned that even if you go through suffering, and you are unable to change your situation, there's a moment where you have to risk it. Mm-hmm. Because it's worth it.
Good.
Because it's going to change everything else.
Good. So let's leave that body. Let's transition out of it. And I'd like to, for you to tell me, what happens to your soul after you leave it? Where do you go?
I become a white string.
Mm-hmm. A white string?
That travels up.
All right. Let's see where you go. Tell me all about your journey.
I feel like there's almost like a magnet that's pulling me in. It's almost like I'm a ray, like a ray of this ball of light.
Mm-hmm. Where do you go?
And it's just pulling me in, it's pulling me in.
Mm-hmm.
And I can, like, go through, I see the universe.
What are you seeing?
Just flashes of outer space, and mm-hmm. it's like just rushing.
Mm-hmm.
And I trust, like, I'm stretching out, and I trust that, like, what would be like my head if I was like a string,
mm-hmm.
my head is like gonna be touching where I come, like, it's gonna, like, I'm headed the right direction.
All right, so let's keep heading in the right direction, and let's see if anybody greets you along the way, or you see anybody. Where do you go?
I feel like I just become part of this. It's almost like you blow on the, like, those flowers of when you make a wish.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I just integrated. I'm just integrated back.
Integrated back into the light?
Yeah, but there's like no, I have no identity or mm-hmm. no nothing. It's just.
How does that feel?
It's weird mm-hmm. because there's no, because I could be like a just again, like a tool. I'm just like a part of something else.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, but I trust that something else. So I don't. I'm not asking for anything more.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I'm being soothed. I'm being nurtured. I'm being, like, taken care of. I'm like, my consciousness is elsewhere.
Very good. Okay. So let's see what happens after a while, where you decide to come back as someone else.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me what the process is.
There's two men, people,
mm-hmm.
for me.
Mm-hmm.
Just all like a white robes, mm-hmm. like from the neck down, just like almost like a bell, like just
mm-hmm.
And I feel like I'm coming up with ideas, or mm-hmm. I'm coming up with, like, possibilities. and they're either gonna agree with me or they're gonna tweak it.
All right.
But I kind of have a choice to like make my own adventure. I would see like a folder or like I'm like selling a story to them or like not selling it, because obviously like I know my there's like a lesson there, mm-hmm. but I'm kind of just like creating my own lesson.
So what do you come up with?
It's a happy life.
It's a happy life.
Mm-hmm. Like this time around, like I'm just wanna enjoy and not really deal with too much.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like yeah, like just give me like this little time, like this little moment to like ride the wave and just pleasure and joy.
Mm-hmm.
Like let's not deal with too many like drastic things. Like I know I have to go through that, but this time around I just want to like enjoy.
Just enjoy it. So let's see how you select who's going to be riding this wave with you.
Hmm. There's like there's like pictures, there's like characters, there's like other people that are not there at the moment, but have agreed to be there.
Mm-hmm.
Friends.
Are these part of your group?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what happens after you pick them?
It's agreed that I'm gonna have a light load.
Mm-hmm.
Although everyone else is gonna have a heavy load, like a heavier load, I'm just gonna kind of, since I've always become like the observer, or like this time around I just get to enjoy it.
So let's see that life now. See yourself now in that life. Tell me where you are.
I feel like it's this life.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like my responsibilities, everything is just really like light,
mm-hmm.
really thin. And I get to see everyone else like go through the hard times.
Mm-hmm. So as you're in this life, I'd like to go for you to go back to that moment when you had that dream in your childhood, when you had that apparition with the rainbow. Mm-hmm. See yourself back into that moment. Go drifting and floating back to that time. And be in that dream now. Where are you?
I'm the viewer. I'm right above my child self.
Mm-hmm.
So I can see myself, and actually that the other vision was me, mm-hmm. but not me now. It's like me in like in the future.
Mm-hmm. So as you look at this rainbow, what is the significance of you looking through the rainbow at a different time?
I'm just saying hi to myself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just kind of recognizing that. I just want to recognize myself,
mm-hmm.
at that stage.
Yes.
Do
you feel that that stage in that life is at this moment of now?
Repeat that.
Do you think that that stage in which you are looking and saying hello to yourself is at this moment of now, or is it?
No, it wasn't. It was okay. Now there's okay. So the one in the rainbow is it's my perfected part.
Perfected part. Okay.
And then my childhood one is my potential.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm about myself, and that's the now.
Okay. So what do you get from this dream? What is the message that you were telling your child self?
I feel the message is for the me now.
Mm-hmm.
It was never intended for the child.
Mm-hmm. What's the message?
Just to acknowledge that potential and to look at the end result and to put in the work that I need to put in, because that's my duty and it's going to get accomplished. I just need to keep moving forward and not get too complacent.
Mm-hmm.
And go back to that potential and that power and that creative force, because it's not over.
Very good. Very good. So now let's leave that scene and now let's go to the dream with your nephew, Dante, when you were with the dolphins. Tell me what's happening in that dream.
I'm not part of the dolphins.
Mm-hmm.
Dante is part of the dolphin.
Mm-hmm.
And I have the pleasure of meeting these elders. I think he's just choosing me as a, like, I'm like, this is the people that supported me while I went through my adventure, my ordeal, and they haven't seen they're trying to relate to a human.
Mm-hmm.
And as a gift, just for me being there, just for like the opportunity, they're giving me that lesson, and I get to ask whatever question I want.
So let's find out what questions you ask these dolphins.
It goes along with like the next part of the dream, where my question was, why do people suffer, or like why? Because I was with this woman that had passed away, and with her family resenting her, but they were all souls, and I had the question, why are you unhappy if you are in heaven, in a way? Why does heaven look like a dilapidated room with unhappy people?
Mm-hmm. What answer do you get for that?
That we all choose to be where we want to be.
Mm-hmm.
It's all a choice. And sometimes it's just a sad choice.
Okay.
But that was my question and that was my answer. And that was my reward.
Very good. So let's find out about the dream with the Victorian women.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like for you to see yourself back into that dream and tell me what's happening.
They're there for inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
They're there to give me a taste of what they went through. They're kind of escaping from where they were. They're not supposed to be doing what they were doing.
All right, tell me what they were doing.
They were sneaking into my subconscious.
Mm-hmm.
To kind of not modify, but just to give input to my artwork.
Mm-hmm.
There were two friends.
What happened to them?
They led a normal life, but I feel like they were in love.
Mm-hmm. Who were they in love with?
Each other.
Mm-hmm.
They're a couple.
Mm-hmm. Do they still inspire you today?
They're still waiting for me to manufacture what they want me,
mm-hmm.
what I have to do.
Are these women supposed to be there? Or are they supposed to be in the light?
They're supposed to be in the light.
Mm-hmm.
They kind of giggle.
Mm-hmm.
They kind of like, oh, we're trying to get away with it, but I know we're not going to, so.
Mm-hmm. Would they like to go to the light today, now that they have the opportunity?
As long as he does what he has to do.
All right, so let me talk with these women now. Who would like to speak with me? Is there one in particular?
Joanna.
Joanna. Let me bring Joanna up. I'm going to count from 1 to 3. Tap your forehead and speak with Joanna. 1, 2, and 3. Good afternoon, Joanna.
Hello.
What are you doing there with Jaime?
We're just playing with him.
Mm-hmm. What's your partner's name?
Melissa.
Melissa. So, Joanna, you and Melissa have been playing with him for a while, haven't you?
We've been waiting for a while.
Mm-hmm. What is it that you're waiting for?
For a vision.
Mm-hmm.
For our voice to be heard.
So, what would you like to say, Joanna?
I just want to pressure him to make some artwork.
Mm-hmm.
Use those garments. Use intuition. We have a voice. We're still in there as well.
Mm-hmm.
Our experiences are in there. Our sweat is in there. Our bodies were wrapped around there.
Mm-hmm. How is it that you and Melissa died? What happened to you?
We didn't die together.
You didn't. How did you die?
Just natural causes.
Mm-hmm. And what about Melissa? How did she die?
I don't know. I wasn't in her life then.
Okay. All right. So, Joanna, are you ready to take off now and go to the light? What are you afraid of?
Ending.
Well, there is no ending. It's only a beginning. Just like all of that art is always a beginning. Every life is a beginning. Wouldn't it be nice to finally go home?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead and pull all that influence that you have from him. Where is it that you're residing?
It's on his, like, a left armpit.
Left armpit. Okay, pull all your influence out there. And Jaime, are you ready to let her go?
Yes, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. All right, so go ahead and tell her that we're going to send her off with love.
What's her name?
Joanna.
Joanna, we're going to send you off with love.
All right.
Where you belong.
All right. Joanna, you ready to go?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm going to ask the angels of the white light to surround you, Joanna. And they always whisper something to you. What do they tell you?
You're safe.
Mm-hmm. So go ahead through the crown of his head, please. Archangel Michael is ready to take you directly to the light. Tell me when you see him.
I sense him.
Mm-hmm.
I sense like a triangle, like three of them.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the top.
Yes, go ahead and go with him. And he's going to take you right to the light. And just tell me who you see there. Who's there to greet you?
All my family. My husband, my children.
How does it feel to be with him? With all your family?
I'm happy.
Very good. Joanna, may the light of the universe always accompany you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And now let me speak with Melissa. Melissa, how are you this afternoon?
I'm good.
Melissa, where is it that you've been hanging out?
Right next to her.
Right next to her. Why is it that you didn't go to the light?
Because I shadow Joanna, so mm-hmm. I need to leave now.
Mm-hmm. So go ahead and start pulling out all your influence from your from his body, please. And are you ready to go? All right, let's get the angels to surround you. What do they tell you?
You're also safe.
Mm-hmm. All right, so go ahead through the top of his head. Archangel Michael will lead the way. Go ahead and follow him. And tell me who you see, Melissa.
Also my husband, children,
mm-hmm.
Joanna.
Mm-hmm. Joanna's there.
Her family, everyone's there.
Mm-hmm. It's a big party, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
May the light of the universe accompany you, Melissa. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. So now that we have all of that taken care of, let me speak now with the higher self. Do I have permission to speak with the higher self?
Yes.
Very good. I know that you could have shown him in many different lifetimes today. Why did you show him the one of that little tiny troll, that little woman, that scribe?
It was a transition towards the human priest,
mm-hmm.
which is basically the same parallel life.
Mm-hmm.
But I was just showing how it was. There was no worries in her world. There was, she worried because she chose to worry.
Yes.
Her scribbling, there were scribbles. They were not that important. She just chose to make it more important, or just burden herself with it, because if she actually looked at what she was writing, it was all pleasure and smiles and happiness.
Mm.
So there is no need for that burden.
Mm-hmm.
And I say that's the same for him now. There's no need to burden himself, because if he looks at his life, it's a pretty simple life that he asked for.
Mm-hmm.
And he should just focus on the pleasure and on the beauty.
What was going on with the priest then?
He just chose to be part of something that was important to him.
Mm-hmm.
But he also had the longing of creating a life, a different life, quote unquote normal life, mm-hmm. with a wife and children, and just have that pleasure. But he chose what he thought was more meaningful at that time, or more important, because that information was sensitive.
Was it the Bible he was writing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Was sensitive, and therefore he had to, that was more important.
Okay. Very good. So what is his purpose now? He chose a very simple life.
Yeah.
But what is he supposed to be doing in this simple life?
Just to be an example of positivity, a reflection of others.
Mm-hmm.
Acceptance, of choosing what will affect your life, mm-hmm. and how it affects you, and just change your perspective once in a while, even if like go to AB and you think you're being creative, go to point C and see what it looks like.
Mm-hmm.
Because it may be more interesting. It may be more, the solution might be easier, and more, it might work better.
Mm-hmm.
So, just being open.
So how is he doing now with his career?
He's almost overqualified to where he's at now.
Mm-hmm.
He's learning, and he needs to take charge. He's been creating forever, and he needs to learn how to teach others in order for that vision to be accomplished faster.
Mm-hmm. Will that give him the ability to work with other people? Because right now he's like a hermit.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. He just has to expose himself. He just has to be vulnerable.
Mm-hmm.
He has to be willing to fail.
Mm.
he does everything because it's his way, and he can almost sense when failure is coming, so he modifies. And failure is good sometimes because, again, you have to find solutions, and those solutions will create another level of durability or of hardness of interest.
So he has to now kind of step up and get more people into his circle, helping him out or teaching them, being a mentor?
Exactly.
Okay, good.
He's always searching for a mentor. He doesn't realize that he just has to switch roles now and
be the mentor.
Yeah.
Okay.
He's at that stage.
What type of energy work would fit his intuition best that would benefit himself and others?
He one-on-one.
One-on-one?
Yeah, just by teaching someone, there's like several layers of teaching. Mm-hmm. And he is teaching how to create stuff, how to build stuff, how to design things, how to be efficient. And that alone is beneficial. Mm-hmm. That alone is reinforcing other someone else's, not ego, but their self-love, their self-worth. So just empowering them one-on-one.
Okay.
That's energy.
That's energy. Because we had talked briefly about how energy, anytime you're doing any type of movement in a place, mm-hmm. it's using your energy. Selecting a table at a restaurant or, right. in his case, selecting the best place to place something. Mm-hmm. Would he benefit from doing any type of energy work as far as placement of things for people? Or is that something that's not of his interest?
No, he's interested in it, but he's not interested in decorating. He's interested in...
creating?
On healing.
Healing.
Yeah. And space itself, if it's positioned correctly, is you heal with it.
Wonderful.
Okay. Yeah.
Good. Wonderful. We had talked briefly about his ancestors, and he didn't quite want to call in, but how are his ancestors? Are there any that are helping him now?
His grandma.
Mm-hmm. Which one?
Gabriela. She's around.
She's around? What did she do for
him? She was around earlier.
Mm-hmm.
She's a different being now.
Mm-hmm. Not the same personality.
No, she's shed everything.
Mm-hmm. Does she have a message for him today?
She's just pushing for him to activate, mm-hmm. and to create something that's more he creates things that are ephemeral, almost. They exist for a certain time and then they don't exist anymore,
mm-hmm.
and she kind of wants him to build or something with more, that's more solid, that's more
long-lasting,
yeah. Mm-hmm. But I think that's him.
Mm-hmm.
She's just pushing him to continue living life,
okay.
really, just to expose himself, to just take those steps that he has to take.
Mm-hmm.
She wants to be able to communicate through him, but he doesn't want that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of a no deal.
Okay. But that was the message she wanted to tell him today?
Yeah. That mm-hmm. I'm here. I want you to reassess our connection. I can teach you as well. But I respect if you don't want to be part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's along like tarot and like communicating that way.
Mm-hmm.
She misses being on Earth.
She does miss being on Earth. Okay. Did she ever go to the light?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So it's up really up to Jaime whether he wants to open up that communication with her in the future. Good.
Yeah, yeah. She's, again, looking at A, looking at B. He needs to look at the C version of Grandma.
Okay.
Because she's a different
version.
Yeah.
She's not the same person he remembers.
No.
Okay. What about Dante? How is he doing?
Amazing.
Amazing. Okay. Does he have anything to say to him? To his cousin today?
Nephew. No, he's transformed and he's kind of everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
He's gone beyond. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Good. Very good. Would you tell me what's going on with his childhood home in Tijuana? What's in that home that everybody has recurring dreams about?
It's just a bunch of like convoluted energies.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like just like a clash, like there's just like a rupture in there of energy.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a crack on like a multiverse or something. Like mm-hmm. it's just leaking, spewing. So there's just all types of energies.
Mm-hmm. Can we get a bunch of angels to go in there and clean that up today?
Yeah.
All right. So I'd like to direct Archangel Michael to take his team to that home and whatever resources he needs to clean up that energy and close that portal.
Mm-hmm.
And tell me what you are envisioning.
It's a it's like a compression of realigning. It's almost like a shattered mirror. They're just kind of like gluing it back together.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a four, just for like the fourth dimension.
The fourth dimension?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just cleansing it. They're just cleaning it.
Okay.
Can we
disconnect it from all the family members that seem to have been connected to that?
That's their choice as well.
Okay.
But him can detach.
Okay. So we have him detaching now. Where is this attachment? Where is he attached to it? Anywhere in his body? In his energetic body?
It's like the left heel.
Okay, so let's go ahead and detach from it, Jaime.
It's like a water pipe.
All right, let's pull that out. We don't need to be connected to that home anymore.
No.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that home anymore either.
It's gone. Good. Anything else that he's attached to right now? Or are we clean? Any other energetic attachments that he has?
No, he's been working on it.
Good.
He's been listening to us.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Yeah.
So would you do a body scan on him now and let's see how his health is doing?
South is fine. He just needs to exercise.
Okay.
He just needs to maintain a level of health. Now that he's like on the brink of like, you know, 10, 20 years, like his body's gonna start taking its toll.
Mm-hmm.
As his body used to take care of him, now he needs to take care of his body.
Okay.
He needs to like make a commitment.
Mm-hmm. And exercise.
Yeah.
What is going on with the lower left rib cage? Is that the knife that we found in that life?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Has that been cleared now?
It's clear.
Good. What about his blood pressure? What's causing that to always go up?
That's just genetics. That's just how his circulation moves.
Okay.
That's exactly why he needs to
To exercise?
Yeah.
He needs to get that heart pumping?
Yes.
Okay. Why is it that he periodically gets eczema on his index finger, his chest, and on his mustache area?
Yeah. The chest part is just the fact that he's been blocking his heart.
Okay.
So it's just that energy that needs to, like, come out.
Mm-hmm. What about his index fingers?
That's just his creativity. Sometimes he actually, there's certain chemicals that, the materials that he works with just irritate him. But he just needs to wear gloves or just be aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't give it much meaning. It'll go away fast.
Okay, what about the little patches on his mustache?
He just needs to smile more.
Ah, okay. He's not exercising enough?
No. No, okay. those lips, no.
So what can we do to unblock his heart right now? What's going on with his heart?
It's just releasing of old people, old love.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to just make room for new people, more new energy, and not rely too much on his past experiences,
because
everything will be different. It's up to him. He can be sad one day and depressed and be in the same exact situation the next day, which is a sweet situation. And his attitude, and then he's happy, and then it's like, oh, he looks at the positive. But the positive is always there, so focus on that. And there's more positive than negative.
Why is it that he keeps fluctuating? Every time he finishes a job, he goes into this sadness.
It's just like postpartum. It's just part of his cycle. Part of that, he thinks that he needs to have a down in order to have a high. But he can avoid it, and we're teaching him. We're telling him how to do it.
Very good. Is there any type of forgiveness exercise that we need to do today because of his heart? Do we need to get anything of that out?
We've done that.
Good. Good. Is there anything else that you would like to tell him today?
That he's on the right path.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to activate. He needs to keep his word. He needs to not lie to himself.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to just be honest and make a commitment to himself and not to others.
Mm-hmm.
Because it only affects you. So I'm proud of you. You're on the right path. You need to, don't think about yourself as like this old, like life is just about to shift for you again. So be happy and look forward to it. Embrace it.
Good. Why did you bring him here today?
He just needed reassurance.
Mm-hmm.
He needed to talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
He needed to be listened to, heard.
Mm-hmm.
That was it. That was the way you guide. He's always looking for a mentor, so like the way you guide is a really gentle. You're the driver, but you're not going where you're going or where you want to take them. You let them guide as well.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, it's a really healthy way to heal, because there's no judgment. There's acceptance. There's understanding. And there's hope always, and everything continues. Everything's in motion, and you kind of you just shake them from their little bumps, or like just rev up their engines. So easier for that.
Good. Do you think that we accomplished that today?
Yeah.
Good. Good. Is there anything else, or are we complete today?
No, we're complete.
Very good. So, while we're signing off, I'd like for you to go ahead and seal his aura, align his chakras, fill him with that beautiful white light from head to toe. And Jaime, I'd like for you to see yourself back into that beautiful meadow where we began with that tall grass, and encapsulate yourself in that beautiful golden cocoon, because we're ready to come back now. Mm. And I'm going to count from 1 to 5, and with each number, you'll be waking up more and more. And when I get to number 5, you'll open your eyes with complete control of your mind and your body. Wide awake now. Wide awake, feeling wonderful all over.
Well,
welcome back.
Thank you.
What do you think about this experience?
It's great. Yes, yeah.
The part about the scribe was pretty.
Yeah, I feel like there's like all these like circles that like.
Mm-hmm. Came back.
Yeah. It was really interesting. Yeah.
I think it kind of makes you understand why you lived that hermit lifestyle.
Completely.
You did it before, and it's kind of comfortable for you.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm going to be creative like this, just like you were as that priest, and I don't need to be around anybody else.
But yeah.
It's kind of a lonely life. You still have that yearning.
Yeah. It was almost like all resentful. It was like this, yes. Like, it was like on the brink of like not being, like not really accomplishing your duty.
Right.
So.
But now in this life, you have the opportunity to finally fulfill that, you know, feeling of being with friends and people. And
yeah, my life is so simple, so nice.
Yeah, and you picked it.
Yes, you picked it that I know. Such
now
a,
you understand.
Yeah, it's a gift.
I don't want I any complications. It. So how long do you feel you're on this journey?
I have no clue. Maybe like 40 minutes.
Yeah, it's about an hour. An hour, right now we're on 1 hour and 15 uh-huh. minutes or so. Yeah, but it was simple to the point. Your higher self came in really strong.
Yeah, I felt like that, like, like, what? He's like, I'm going to not kick your ass, but, like, just going to tell how it is.
Yeah, it was. It was very strong.
Yeah, it was good.
How did
I recognize that, like, that
voice.
That, yeah.
Well, he's been talking to you.
Yeah.
And also your grandmother.
Yeah.
Wants to tell you basically, hey, you're not, I'm not the same person that you're.
Yeah, it's interesting.
That's the human part of me.
Uh-huh.
You know, I've got a lot more to share with you when you're ready.
Right.
Excellent.
Yeah, that was great.
Do you think you want to share this, or is you want to keep it private?
I'll share it. I don't know exactly what I, like.
Well, we could cut out parts that are personal.
Yeah, I don't think there was anything. Again, I don't know.
Do you remember anything?
Yeah. I do. Okay. I think I remember all of it. It's just kind of fleets, like. Yeah, I know nothing. Like, there's no like surprise or like, you know, nothing that I'm like, oh my god, no.
No.
Nothing.
No. Cool.
Yeah.
Great. So let's disconnect you and let's take. All right. Back. So here we are in Los Angeles. We just had a very nice and sweet session.
Yeah.
So tell everybody how this experience was for you. What did you get from it?
It was a great experience. I came in with like no expectations, and and I think it was really interesting.
Yeah.
It just reinforced a lot of like my thoughts that I suppress, like the positive good stuff that I think about myself. It just reinforced that, which is really nice. Yeah.
And I know that the part about the priest was pretty, it seemed to be really hitting home there.
Yeah.
What did you get from that?
It was weird because there was this, like, before the actual priest, there was this deep sadness.
Mm.
And, like, just deep sadness that I'm like, where is this coming from? And then it attached to, like, the priest story. I'm like, oh, that's what's going on.
Yeah, he had such a sense of duty.
Yeah.
But at the same time, he knew he was going to miss out on his whole life.
Yeah.
So when you came here, it's like, no more drama. Let's just do it simple.
Yeah, exactly.
So he chose a life where, you know, he just was going to skate along real, real nice.
Well, next time, God knows what's going to happen. But this one was like a little freebie. So
nice.
I'm thankful.
So what was it like to be in hypnosis? Tell everybody what it feels like.
I don't know if I can explain it, but it was like nothing scary, nothing like weird. Nothing. It was just kind of... paying attention to yourself and just
kind of like your intuition, right?
Yeah, your intuition. Just don't hold back. Don't edit yourself and the stories. And
what does your higher self feel like?
It's not dominance, but it's just like no BS, just straight through. Just And I won't say cutthroat either, because it's like really just gentle and soft, yes, and nice. But self-assurance, like, yes, that, like, just...
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I felt like.
So what would you, how would you, what would you like to tell them on how to prepare for something like this? How did you prepare?
By leaving my expectations at home, basically.
Yeah.
And just being open. Open-minded, open-hearted, just going with it. Not challenging your, like, anything. Just smooth line.
Yes, yes.
And that was, it was great. It worked well.
Good. So if you would like a session with me, all you have to do is go to my website, albaweinman.com. And I also travel. As you see, I'm in Los Angeles now. I'll be traveling all over the place. So just go to my website, the Out of Town tab, and you can see where I'm going to next. So until the next time, thank you very much for watching. Bye.
Bye-bye.
I get my hug now.
Of course.
Oh.